Hi, everybody. It's Mike from 1614 Fitness. We are about to give you my favorite episode. It's goals. How to set them, why to set them, and characteristics of good goals. Stick around, won't you? Hi, everybody. It's Mike with my favorite episode from 1614 Collection. It is the episode on goals. Now, why do I feel so strongly about goals? Well, I think goals can help make people happier. I think goals can improve one's position in life and work. And I just think it keeps you moving. And for me, movement is hugely important. I'm a big fan of that. And I'll share with you why. Our body, depending on who you talk to, 60 to 80% water. So I think there's some parallels there between our body and water. Moving water, movement, creates life at the cellular level. It absolutely provides an environment where things can live and breed and the food chain can begin or end. And also, that moving water helps create energy. Back at the very beginning of our country, settlements huddled around rivers and streams. It creates life. Moving water is precious. Water that stays still, stagnant, can kill you. It can foster an environment that is the antithesis of life. It is absolutely dreadful. Moving water, great. Stagnant water, dreadful. The human body, the same thing, really. If you sit down, just sit down in a chair and don't move, within 48 hours, your body begins to atrophy. Atrophy is just a fancy word of breaking down. You will begin to break down muscle tissue. You'll begin to become weaker and softer. And really, you're truly breaking down at the molecular level. You're falling apart. Conversely, if you run, if you move, if you remain active, your body and your life and your health can flourish. Moving water, good. Moving body, good. Stagnant body, stagnant water, dreadful. And I'm a firm believer that if you set goals, you're going to move. You're going to go places you might not otherwise go. So let's create some goals. One of my favorite lines is, if you're not going somewhere, you're going nowhere. It sounds a little elementary, I guess, but it's true, isn't it? If I don't have some place to go, what am I doing? I'm not going anywhere. A better quote maybe is from Andrew Carnegie. His quote is this: if you want to be truly happy, select a goal that commands your thoughts, liberates your energies, and inspires your hopes. That's a mouthful that I wish I came up with. But doesn't that really embody everything I'm trying to say to you? It's just absolutely a fantastic thought. If you have a goal, it's going to create a ton of opportunities for your thought, your spirit, your mind. Here's something that happens to me all the time. I'm a trainer. Folks come in, they want me to train them. They come in all geared up. They got their water bottle, they got their sneakers, they got their sweats, they got their shirt, they're all ready to go. And the first thing I say to them is, hey, come on, let's go meet and talk in my office. You can see the in their eyes because they were excited to work out. And they can't for the life of them figure out why I don't want to work out. And I don't. I want to sit and talk. They quickly think that this is a monster waste of time. But right from the giddy up, I think this is the most significant thing that we're going to do in terms of our relationship. So we sit down and we talk. And the first thing I want to know is, what is it that you want to do? And they start talking and they start talking. And I'm convinced from years and years of marketing and TV ads and cereals that are going to help you do this and bars that are going to help you do this and new weight, this and that, they immediately say, I want to lose 20 pounds. And I don't know whether they really want that or they just want to shut me up so we can get out there and work out. But regardless, that's what they say. But through it all, I keep talking and I keep talking and I keep talking because I want to know what really it is that they want. Here's a specific story about a gal I met 100 years ago. We were doing just that. We're sitting down, we're talking, and we're going over our goals and this and that. And she also, truth be told, wanted to lose 20 pounds. But I knew that wasn't that significant. I kept talking to her and talking to her. And before long, I realized that there was a trend. She kept bringing up a trip. She kept bringing up her husband, and she kept bringing up a bikini. So I said, listen, I hear the 20 pounds, but what is it that you really want? And then I challenged her. I hear your husband, I hear bikini, I hear trip. What is it that you want? And she immediately became emotional and began to cry. And she says, Mike, we've been married for, I don't remember this, 15 years maybe. I've never once wore a bikini in front of my husband. We're going away in 3 months, and I'd love nothing more than a chance to wear that bikini. I said, hon, there's your goal. That right there is a perfect goal. That goal will motivate you and inspire you to get out of bed and work. That goal will motivate and inspire you to do things that you might not really be willing to do for that scale. See, losing 20 pounds is great, and losing 20 pounds may get her in that bikini, but sometimes you need something more tangible to get your arms around to motivate you to make it happen. And we're going to talk about that over the next course, the next 10, 15 minutes of this episode. Just please stay tuned and check this out. So that being said, we wrote it down. We did all that good stuff. And when it was all said and done, she made her goal. She sent me a picture of her red bikini, her husband on a beach somewhere. And I really don't believe that if the goal would have been 20 pounds, it would have happened. Enough about her. So what is a goal? A lot of folks think they have goals, and I just think they're desires or whims. That's what I call them. They might be shown as, you know what, I think I'm going to run a 5K. You know what, I'm going to lose that 20 pounds. Or, you know, I think I might go back and get my degree. I think those are desires or whims. They're just thoughts that popped into my head that really haven't turned in anything more than that. So the question is, how do you turn a whim or a goal, I'm sorry, a whim or a desire into a goal? First thing you got to do is you have to give it life. You have to make it tangible. You got to make it real. And for me, we're going to do just what she did. We're going to write it down. Write that goal down and make it real. Make it tangible. Make it something you can hold. And don't just write it down once. Write it down a couple different times and put it in places. Put it in places that you're going to see on an everyday basis. I call them, put them in life's intersections. A life intersection might be a refrigerator, might be the dash of your car, might be your computer terminal, but put it in places that you see it. We all know that old phrase, out of sight, out of mind, and let's face it, that's true. If you don't think about it, you don't see it, it just goes away. Magically, it's gone. Conversely, if I put it in sight, it's going to tend to stay in mind. So put that goal in strategic places. Your mirror in your bathroom, your dash of your car, all these places that you're going to see it. Keep it in front of you. Make it real. So we're going to give it life. We're going to turn it on by writing it down. That's a great step, but that's still not a goal in my world. That's still not what we need to do, because we'll go back to my friend. She had a goal of getting into a bikini on the vacation date. What we have to do is now take that goal and create urgency. Give it urgency by giving a date. That's huge. If I have an open-ended goal, I'm going to run a 5K. Don't have a date in mind. I just want to run a 5K. The likelihood of that happening isn't so great because there's no urgency to it. Urgency is key. Ask any parent or teacher that's trying to get a child to do a book report. Sense of urgency is huge in getting it done. Typically, they're going to start that homework the day before. And that's not going to work. So I'm going to run a 5K October 22nd, and I'm going to sign it. And I will sign it. So now I've given it life. I've written it down. I've established urgency. I've put a date, and I do like to sign it. And now I've got that set out all around my home, all over the place. So I see it, and it becomes absolutely, truly real. But now we've got a challenge. Because now it seems as though everything we needed is done. My goal is set. I want to run a 5K by October 31st, whatever date, forgive me for forgetting, but that's my goal. Not quite. We have to validate it. We've got to see how badly I want this goal. My gal that I worked with earlier, she wanted it badly. It brought up emotion. There were tears involved. That's a wonderful goal because I know there's an emotional buy-in. It goes back to the scale. There's no emotional buy-in with that scale. It's ridiculous. Unless you're Flavor Flav and you're going to wear it around your neck, it's insignificant. I need emotional buy-in. So when I have my clients do their goal, I go, great. On a scale of 1 to 10, how badly do you want this goal? 1 being, 10 being, I want it so badly I can taste it. Hers was a 10. I knew we were going to get it. I knew she would do what she had to do. So much so, I asked her to buy that bikini and secretly hang in her closet just to keep that motor going. So how badly do you want it? You have to validate your goal so you know if you're lying to yourself or not. All right? Think about it. I may think I want it, but for me to run a 5K or me to go do something drastic requires change. You can't expect to have change without implementing change in your life. And we as people don't always like change. Change is kind of scary. It's uncomfortable. Think about it. Some of the best or most popular TV shows were the ones that did the same thing over and over and over and over. Change for a lot of people isn't welcomed. So you have to ask yourself, do I really want it? Here's a quick story about a young man who wanted desperately, he thought, to go back and get his degree. At the time, he had a good job, had spending money, had free time where he could work a couple hours at a bar, had extra money so he could drive around in a sports car, and he thought to himself, this is fantastic. But he didn't get his degree, and he realized some of the folks he originally went to school with had gotten their degree and were passing him professionally. That caused him to say to himself, maybe on a whim, I got to go back and get my degree. So he does, and he even writes it down. He even comes up with a date, but he never validated it. He never asked himself how badly does he want it. So he goes back, takes a couple classes, finishes those, does well, takes a couple more. But all of a sudden, that extra financial cushion that he had is gone because he can't work as much. He can't work the extra job. He's got to pay for books. He's got to pay for the classes themselves. And all of a sudden, he's running out of money. But he can't work those extra hours anymore because he's got to study. Oh, this is becoming ugly. And he can't really afford that sports car anymore because, well, of the reasons I just mentioned. Now, all of a sudden, he no longer works at that cool bar. He no longer has a sports car. And he's doing studies and homework all the time. A few months into this process, he decided maybe that's not what he wanted. And he jumped off the ship before it got too deep. He went back and got his other job, got himself another car. He realized he didn't want it that badly. The gal who got her bikini on, she did. I'm a firm believer. To truly make a goal, you have to give it life. Write it down. Write it down and put it all over the place. Life's intersections. Put it in places that you're going to see it. Give it a date. Give it urgency. First, you got to give it life. Then you got to give it urgency. Then you have to have your come to Jesus, I call it. How badly do I want it? Because you're never going to have change without change. I love that definition of insanity. Insanity is when you do the same thing over and over and over and over and you keep expecting a different result. It doesn't happen. So you have to ask yourself, am I truly willing to accept those changes to reach my goal? When we have goals in my office, I often ask folks, listen, how badly do you want this goal? 1 or 10? And they hem and haw. I go, listen, cut to the chase. Is this goal significant enough for you to get out of your bed on a cold, rainy November Saturday at 7:30 in the morning to come into the gym and do cardio? Is it? And they go, yeah. And then I say, no, is it really? And I can see them thinking. Now, if the answer is yes, we've got ourselves a very good goal. If not, it's probably not going to work. So how do you make a goal come to life? You have to give it life by writing it down. Then you have to give it urgency by giving it a due date. Then you have to validate it and find out how badly you want it. Are you willing to make the sacrifices necessary to make this goal come true? If you are, then we're set. Now, the only other piece of advice I want to give you on the urgency aspect is, if you've got a goal that's this big, that's more than 3, 4, 5, 6 months in duration, I encourage you to cut it up into small chunks. Establish workable parts. So if you do those three things, give it life, give it a sense of urgency, and then validate it, I think you're well on your way to movement and keeping yourself happy. Now, that's how we do those goals. I'd like to offer a quick tidbit in conclusion. I'm going to give you three characteristics of what I think make up a great goal. I think every goal needs to move you. I think it should move you emotionally. I think it should move you physically. I think it should move you cognitively. Let's talk about that real quickly. I do think a goal should move you physically. You should get up and move around. I don't think you necessarily have to have every goal has to be a 5K, an exercise this or an exercise that, but I hope it requires you to get up and move. I hope it requires you to get up and make blood flow. I hope it makes you go from point A to point B, because I guarantee you, in a weird way, that'll make you feel better. So I hope it moves you physically. I also hope it moves you emotionally. I hope it's something so significant, at the end of it, you can sit down and feel good about it. Whether or not it's tears over a bikini, whether or not it's finishing a 5K, whether or not it's going back to get your degree, whether it's getting that promotion, I hope it's serious enough that it causes emotion. And finally, I think it should move you cognitively. Every goal we have needs to make us think. We've got to think. We've got to establish plans. It's got to be significant enough where we got to take a step back and create a plan. And that plan needs to be organized and structured, and it needs to fit into that whole game plan. So I do think a goal should move us physically, it should move us emotionally, it should move us cognitively. That's my thought on goals. If there's anything I can do to help out, please reach out to me via Facebook, the web, or give us a call at the gym at 832-1614. I appreciate your time. See you at the gym.